depends on how much money you make. I mean, I was really lucky. I was in a job that allowed me to afford to have great help. And I was still struggling. So how you do this when you're struggling financially is, you know, an enormous challenge for women. And I'm very appreciative of the resources that I have that gave me a lot of freedom that most people don't have, obviously. But even then, I knew I was missing out on something I didn't want to miss out on. My kids were being raised by nannies, and my older one would cry out for this nanny. Her name is Autumn. And he'd wake up in the middle of the night and he'd cry for Autumn, like, never mommy, it was always Autumn, and that was like killing me. And when I did finally quit, I, in fairness, at CNN, it was a rough, the show was struggling. CNN was going through some real ratings troubles. I was in a time slot against Bill O'Reilly and Keith Olbermann when he was at NBC, and I was under a lot of pressure from CNN to sort of turn my show into more of that kind of aggressive, shout-fest news, which wasn't who I was, and it's not something I felt comfortable with, it just wasn't working. So I fired myself, which I think was smart, because you, in television, will see the writing on the wall. And if I had stayed for a couple of years, I wanted to get out on my terms. So I fired myself, and then I fired the nanny. Because I had to reestablish this bond with my kids, right, when I came home. And I remember, and she understood, she was a great girl, but the day she walked out the door, my kid was banging against the door as she walked out and closed the door behind her, screaming, Autumn, don't leave me, Autumn, don't leave me, and he's bawling. And I'm sitting there thinking, this is terrible, like, I'm never going to be able to establish this maternal bond with my son, and he's always going to be connected to her for the rest of his life, and I'm like really dying inside. And then I said, hey, do you want to go get ice cream? And he nodded his little head, and he never mentioned her name again. So, like, I know, we put all this pressure on ourselves, you know, we convince ourselves that, you know, we're failing as mothers, and it really just takes a little ice cream.